this is Sky Dog to Groundhog. Come in, Groundhog, over.
I told you not to call me that.
You seeing anything? I got nothing up here. Oh, hold on. We've got movement. I repeat, we've got movement.
Copy that. Tell me when.
Look, Ty, I'm trying.
I'm waiting for a response from the dude. Come in, Groundhog.
Do you have a reading, Groundhog?
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to turn off this tribesis, but it's getting a little too big, you know?
Dumb.
Ty, you're on your own.
You've got this.
Are you kidding me?
You all right, small fry?
Yeah, fine, thanks.
Hey, Antonio.
Oh, hey, Sienna. Later, bud.
So what's up this weekend? You gonna be around?
I already told you I have the women's rally on Saturday.
Oh yeah, I remember now. What's the point of that anyway? Like, what are you supposed to do? March on the out people all day?
There are lots of points to this, Joe. Do you even have the slightest idea of the types of sexist things that happen to women on a daily basis?
You know what happened to me today? I asked Roy for a raise, and he said he'd consider it. What kind of bullshit answer is that? I've done so much for that piece of shit.
Right, sure, but let me ask you this. Do you ever get scared to walk alone somewhere, especially when it's dark? Do you ever feel silenced at your job? Like, your ideas might not matter as much as the next guy's. And...
Yeah. No, that's awful, babe. Listen, I gotta go. Good night.
What the? No way. Oh my God. How?
She needs help. I suggest you take her to the emergency room so they can assess her and admit her to a children's psychiatric hospital.
But she's fine.
No, she's not. And I'm going to contact the ER and let them know you're coming.
Don't. I'm not taking her. She is perfectly fine. She is not crazy.
I never said that she was crazy. And I don't want to have to do this. But if you don't take her, I'm going to have to call Child Protective Services. Because she is in danger.
Let's go.
Thank goodness. Not even October yet, and I already have 2 essays to write for my AP English class. Junior...
We're not going home. Dr. Shaw thought it would be best if we admit you to the ER. Hopefully everything will be fine and we can go home after.
But I'm okay.
No! We have to go.
By midnight, I was brought to a children's psychiatric intensive care unit. A mental institution. They diagnosed me with major depression disorder, anxiety disorder, and bipolar disorder. As the days passed by, I kept thinking about going to the bridge. And just ending it all. But something stopped me every time. When you are depressed, you don't always have a reason to feel sad, you just do. Something in your brain literally blocks you from feeling happiness and there's nothing you can do about it. And you cry for no reason and you can't stop it and you want to reach out for help and beg someone to make you feel better, but nothing makes it better. You can't block out the dark thoughts and you can't control your emotions. That is why self-harm feels so good. Because it's the one thing in your life that you feel like you have control over. And it makes you feel something other than sad. Sure, it makes you feel pain, but it also makes you feel more alive than you have ever felt. A week later, I had a group of friends. We were the most popular group in the whole institution. Everyone wanted to be our friend, and I was the leader of the group. We all bonded over our messed up lives, but everyone who was there was fucked up. One kid killed his mom, and when he told me about it, he laughed. He was 7. But they all healed faster than me, and I was left by myself.